Right.
You started off with a life sentence?
That's what I was facing when I went to trial. I had a life sentence. But by the time when I was coming to sentencing, then I ended up with 25 because they hit me with all the people that was testifying, giving me the extra drug.
Right. But then a lot of the people that they had come on your case was lying.
Right. That all I case really, Pancho got jammed up in North Carolina and got sentenced. Well, he didn't get sentenced in North Carolina. He got caught with five keys in North Carolina. Then when him and the three guys, they sent the three guys to prison from North Carolina, they let Pancho go. And when he came back to Tampa, the feds indicted Pancho. Then Pancho, they put them same five keys in Pancho case. And then Pancho debriefed on 13 of us, me and my co-defendants, my family and stuff. And then we end up going to trial with the same five keys. So the same five keys that was in North Carolina was in three different people cases.
Damn, man, them people don't play.
And when I turned back around and told, when I found out about it, like really at sentencing when I was good, because they weren't really giving me all the discovery. When I was going through trying to get it from the lawyers and all that kind of stuff, the prosecutor, when I got in sentencing, that's when I found out, like doing a PSI report where they told me about, I found out about Pancho, because I didn't know who the confidential informant was.
Mm-hmm.
I was trying to figure out, because they didn't catch me with no fire keys. There wasn't no dope caught in the state of Florida, but they had everybody PI. So it was like really six of us ended up going to trial.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But yeah, but it's all. And then we had, during the actual trial, the agent, Kevin McLaughlin, the judge suppressed all our text messages and said we had a Fourth Amendment violation, suppressed it and everything. And during the middle of the trial, she allowed all the evidence to come back in. Disregard the suppression order and everything.
Man, them people don't play, man. I be trying to warn you, dude.
They don't play. But a lot of people, I was talking to them the morning yesterday. I say, man, look, I say, they do a lot of stuff that a person don't realize, though, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, unless you don't been through it from beginning to end, that's the only way you're going to understand that stuff.
Yeah. And it's really just dealing with commerce. That's what it's all based on, commerce.
That's all it is. But you got to think about it. How many people understand commerce?
Right.
Nope.
You know, they basically saying you moving products and operating on our property and you're not giving us anything. You breaking all type of laws. So we need to come see you. That's all it is.
Yeah, that's true. And then it too. You know, hey, they stole. Long as they stole that fear, like out of fear the way I look at it when they came to me. They were facing me with a life sentence.
Right.
That was their fear that they tried to put in me. When I went to the lawyer, I think he said, man, you know, he was like, man, you know, a lot of people taking a plea, man, you know, you might want to consider taking a plea. I said, well, what they offering? So he called up the agent. The agent said, well, if you take a plea today, we'll offer him, what he said? He said, we'll give him 30 years. I said, 30 years for a plea? I said, man, I ain't taking no 30 years for a plea and I ain't got caught with one dime of cocaine or whatever. I said, no, nah, man, you going to trial. I said, I got up and walked out of the lawyer's office. So I ain't got to even see that, though, man.
I mean, you got to go to trial on a situation like that.
I ain't been going to trial for 30 years. I ain't been taking a plea for 30 years. And you didn't catch me with nothing.
And you basically bringing five keys that caught in another state and going to say I had something to do with those five keys. Them keys got caught. That's whoever got caught up there in Carolina shit.
Man, them boys actually did state time in North Carolina. They did actually state time on the five keys. When I got the police report and was reading it from North Carolina, I'm reading it the whole scene. Explain everything how they let Pancho go. As soon as Pancho came back, then that's when the feds indict him. Because I don't know if you remember when Bucci had ran that, I think, in Palm River, and the dirt was flowing.
Oh, yeah, dude.